Good morning, student. I'm Rose. Today we are going to discuss a new chapter of Standard 6, Biology, that is Chapter 2, Components of Food. Okay, so in the last video or the last chapter, we have learned about the food. From where does it come? Yes or no? So mainly the food comes from different plants and animals. Yes or no? And that the source, or we can say main source of the food, where from where we'll get, is called the plants and animals. Yes or no? So there are various ingredients which makes which help us for the which gives us we can say there are various food which gives us energy and it helps us for the growth, and also it also protect us from various kind of disease. Yes or no? So these are the things which we have discussed in the last chapter. So today in this chapter we are going to discuss some of the most important topics in this chapter. First of all, we'll see what are the basic topics which we are going to study. Is the basic component of food, like you can say carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals, and then water and roughage. These are the main basic components of food that we are going to discuss in this chapter. Then again another topic is that test for these all components of food. How we can test the food, or we can say how can we know that this is carbohydrate, this is what they call protein, this is fats. Okay, so this we will do in the lab. Okay, the another topic we are going to discuss is that is the balanced diet, and the last topic we will discuss is the deficiency of disease. Yes sir. So first of all, as we say, why do we need food? Yes or no? Why do we eat food? Yes or no? So first question arises, why do we can say why we eat food? Okay, so mostly we say that because of hunger. Yes or no? Mainly we eat food because of hunger. But one more thing is that we eat food because it gives us energy. It gives us energy. For that purpose we eat, and this energy helps us to do a various activity in our daily life. Yes or no? So for example, you are at home, you need energy for playing, you need energy for studying. Yes or no? So there are various activities or various activities which this food helps us to do in our daily life. Okay, so another, if you talk about why do we what are the varieties of food that means important for our daily life. Okay, so this each varieties of food have each own nutrition. Yes or no? It has its own nutrition, and this all nutrition nutrition need for our body, or we can say it's need for our body, and it helps us to do a various activity in our daily life, or we can say day to day life. Okay, so if you talk about what is nutrition, if you talk about obtaining food necessary for good health and the growth. Okay, so this food is necessary for the good health and also for the growth and development of our body. Okay, so that means we can say then what is the nutrient, if you talk about what is the nutrient, that we can say the food which give energy and help for growth. Yes or no? That means the energy, that means the food we eat, whether it is in the breakfast, whether it is the lunch, whether it is the snacks, whether it is the dinner, whatever food we eat during this all time, all this food gives us various help us in various activity, and it gives us the energy and the it helps for the growth and development of our body. So this is why we take the food and why do we need the food in our daily life. Okay, it not just for just because of the hunger, but this food gives us energy. Okay, so now in the next topic, that is the major components of food. We will discuss what are the major components of food. So there are actually five major components of food, that is the carbohydrates, protein, fats, vitamins and minerals. And this water and roughage are the, it is also essential, but this is not counted in this major components of food. Okay, so these five are the main major component of food which is very necessary for our body. Okay, so first of all we are going to talk about the carbohydrates. Okay, if we talk about the carbohydrates, we eat the carbohydrates in daily life in the form of rice, in the form of potato, in the form of bread, in the form of jelly, in the form of, there are various food which comes under the carbohydrates. Okay, and this carbohydrate is also called the energy giving food. Why it is called the energy giving food? Because it is very cheap and it is the main source of energy. It is very cheap. That means cheap means it doesn't cost much. Okay, so we can get anywhere wherever we go. So it is very easily available in the market or in the environment, and it is the source of energy. It is the source of energy. Due to that, it is called the energy giving food. Okay, so if you classify or if you divide these carbohydrates, it is divided into three parts. That is the sugar, starch, and cellulose. Okay, so these are the three important importantly it is classified. That means if we break down this, we can say what are the sources from where we get the carbohydrates. We can say divide it into three parts. That is the sugar, starch, and cellulose. Okay, so this sugar we get mainly from the rice, or we can say the sugar cane. Then you have the potatoes. Okay, these are the main important source of sugar. Okay, so another, and this sugar is very sweet in taste, and it is also divided into very sweet in taste, and it has been again it is when will we break down into this sugar into a smaller, more simple components, or we can say we find sucrose, glucose, and fructose. That means if you this when this sugar when this sugar break down into a small pieces, it is again we find into a sucrose, glucose, and fructose. Okay, so these are sucrose, glucose, and fructose mainly we find inside our body when after the absorption of body, when it when it transported into different parts of the body. So this is what the sugar. Then starch, if you talk about this starch, mainly comes from the rice, wheat, potatoes. That means mainly comes from the plants. Another is the cellulose. Okay, this work as a roughage, but it is this too. This cellulose and starch are very tasteless, and it doesn't have any color. Okay, so this comes mainly, this cellulose we find in the cell wall of the plants. And it works as a roughage. So these are the three important carbohydrates which gives us energy, to our body. Okay. Another is that if you talk about the glucose, you can see if some of the important chemical formulas. You can see the sugar's chemical formula is C12H22O11, and the glucose you can see C6H12O6. Okay, so this glucose is also called the source of intense energy. Why we call the source of instant energy? Because this glucose, for example, when you run or when you run stuff from somewhere, what happened? You can see the people give you, for the sports, in the sports time, you have already experienced when you run a 50 meter race or 200 meter race. Sometimes what happened? Your breathing, actually what happened? There is so much loss of energy. So when you stop, your teachers give you a glucose water. Yes or no? So this glucose, what this does it do? It directly enters into the bloodstream, and this activates our body, and it gives us energy. This glucose gives a direct energy to our body. So due to that, what happened? This we need for the energy. So this is how it acts in our body. Another, if you talk about, that is the protein. So if you talk about the protein, it is also called the bodybuilding food. Okay, and this protein is very necessary for everybody, for the mainly for the growing children, like we say you or the students. Yes or no? So we need lot of proteins. So protein, if you talk about, where does we can find? Yes or no? For example, we find those are vegetarian, you can eat the pulses, milk. Okay, these are the main ingredients from where we get the protein. And those are non-vegetarian, you can eat fish, egg, chicken. These are the sources of protein from where we get. Okay, so the protein we can get from both plants and animals. Okay, so why does we call the bodybuilding food? Because it gives, or we can say it repairs the worn out cell. That means wherever inside the body where there is worn out cell. Worn out means we can say sometimes you can see any sorry Sometimes you can see in your hands when you get hurt, you can see automatically after some days it is being covered by a smooth muscle. Yes or no? Why? Because this repair, this protein repairs the what we call the broken or torn part of our body, whether it is inside the body or outside, whether it is on the surface of our body. So that is why it is called the bodybuilding food. Okay. Another we will talk about the fats. Another we'll talk about the fats. So this fats, if we talk about, it is mainly found in the ghee, oil, then you have butter. These are the main source of fats. Okay, these are the main source of fats. That and this fats, or we can say this fats is being stored in our liver in the form of a what we call glycogen, in the form of a glycogen. Okay, so what happened? This fats is also called the energy bank. This fats is also called the energy bank. Okay, and it gives us taste and flavor to the flavor to the food which we eat. Okay, so sometimes what happens when we eat excess of fats, like in the butter or ghee or the oil, when we eat excess of this, what happens? It gives it makes us obesity, or we can say one type of disease called obesity. That means we can say so much weight will increase or something like that. Okay, so it is excess of fat, when we intake of excess of fat is also not good. Okay, so there should be a what we call limit of taking any food. Yes or no? So this that is why this energy of this fats is also called the energy bank. That means it stores the energy in the form of a fats. Okay, another if we talk about, that is the vitamins and minerals. Vitamins and minerals, this both vitamins and minerals are also called the protective food. This also called the protective food because it protect the body from disease and build immunity. Okay, so mainly this vitamins and minerals we get from the fruits. Then you have the food, some part of the food. Then mainly the green vegetables we get. Okay, so this that is why this protein, or we can say this vitamins, help us to that is why it is called the protective food, because it build our immunity and also it protect us from the various diseases. Okay, so if you talk about the vitamins, okay, it has different kinds of vitamins. Okay, it is classified into two, that is the fat soluble vitamins and the water soluble vitamins. Okay, in the fat soluble means it contains oil. It contains oil, that means the vitamin A, D, E and K. These four vitamins are mainly a fat soluble vitamins. Okay, and in this D and K vitamins are only vitamins which are being found in inside the body. Okay, and all that is for vitamin A, E, B and C, these are being taken from the different food which we, that means from the outside the body. Only two vitamins that is made in our body is the D and K. Okay, and in this, that means D, E and K are the fat soluble vitamins, and water soluble vitamins are B and C. That means water soluble, why does we call water soluble? Because this can easily dissolve in water. This can easily dissolve in water and we can take in the form of fluid or the liquid. Okay, so that is why it is called the water soluble vitamin. And then if we talk about water and roughage, okay, water and roughage, what are the most important thing is that it helps us to regulate the body temperature. As we know, our body contains 70% of water. Yes or no? So we need lot of water because it regulates the water body temperature, and also it helps us in absorption of all the nutrition that we have taken. Okay, so this helps us for the absorption. That means when it is being absorbed, from the small intestine, it is being transferred to different part of the body. So this helps us, or we can say this water also helps us in carrying the blood, or we can say oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood. So these are the various activity which are being done by water. Another is the roughage. Roughage, if you talk about, it clean our body. That means the main source of called roughly it is called the salad, the fibrous food, like you can say fruits, salad. Okay, these are the fibrous food, and it is also called the dietary fibers. It is also called the dietary fibers because it helps us to clean our body. Okay, so these are the main components of food which we studied today. Tomorrow, or we can say in the next video, I'll teach you something about the test of these all components of food, like this is starch, protein, and fats. See you in the next video. Thank you.